Some of you guys might look at me like I don't make mistakes, and trust me, I make mistakes each and every single day. That's how we learn. I've launched hundreds of funnels, and I still can make mistakes, right? So one thing I want you guys to learn from that. Hey, what's going on, Empire Builders? Welcome back to another episode. Today, you are in for a big treat. I'm gonna be giving you guys a quick 5-day case study of a funnel that we recently launched for a client. We're gonna be analyzing the results together, and also we're gonna be showing you exactly how you can do this for yourself. Now guys, before we get going, I want to announce the winner of our last 30-minute coaching session giveaway. We're going to flash your name magically right there. If that's you, email Peter at e-commerce empire builders to schedule your free coaching call with me. And if you want to be a lucky winner, all you have to do is drop a comment down below on today's video and make sure you hit that notification bell. Make sure you hit that subscribe button so you're tuned in every single Monday, Wednesday, Friday as we release new content here on the channel. But guys, today I'm really excited to bring you guys something very special. Recently we started launching a lot of new funnels, not just for ourselves, but for clients as well, and I thought it would be really helpful for you to see exactly how we analyze results, how we scale the businesses during the early stages. The early stages of when you're starting an e-commerce business or an e-commerce dropshipping business or any business in general is usually the most volatile, and you're gonna see that in the results that we're going over here. And the thing is, a lot of times you just kind of have to stick with it, analyze the results, don't get too emotionally attached in it. So again, this is a brand new business that we recently built out for one of our clients. This is a dropshipping funnel that we built out, and I'm gonna be showing you guys exactly all the steps that we took to launch this business and also next steps for that business as well. All right, so let's get right into this, guys. So before we go into the actual stats, I wanna kind of give you some context here, okay? Because it's not like you just turn ads on and you make money, okay? It doesn't work out that way. You wanna plan this out. So what we were leveraging here is Facebook ads. We did not do influencers here. Usually those are the two avenues that we like to launch businesses on. For this specific offer, this specific niche, we thought, hey, you know what? Fastest results we'll be able to get through Facebook ads, which we did. Now, before you go into Facebook ads, guys, something really important to understand is you have to make sure you have variation, okay? Make sure that you have some new images, make sure you have some videos. We're gonna be going into how we structure these campaigns in a moment here, but I wanna get into right along with the stats. So day number one, when we launched our initial Facebook ads, our budget was roughly $30 a day. We essentially broke even, which is not bad at all. If I break even on a new business, guys, I'm already a seven-figure business because I understand how to monetize the back end. So even when you break even on that first sale, that's completely okay. So this was a very good sign to us when we initially launched this business. We made roughly $40 in sales, average cart value being $20. And you could see here's our kind of how our funnel is. So I blurred out a lot of this stuff just for our clients' privacy. But what we did here when we set up this business is there's a few things. Those of you that have been following, you know, me and the e-commerce empire builders for a while, maybe you're a student, maybe you're an Inner Circle member. One thing that what we use here is sales funnels. We don't use a Shopify store. We don't really use like WooCommerce or general storefronts, especially for cold traffic, as you guys see here with Facebook ads. We really want to highlight one specific offer and give our customers a lot of good deals along the way. So you can see here, this first step is essentially our order form where we offer quantity based discounts. So you can see here, obviously we made two sales, right? We made two sales, but there was a person that bought more than one. We also like to put order bumps in here as well. These rows right here are all upsells. These two upsells are selling complimentary products, right? More premium priced products, a little bit more expensive in order for us to kind of increase our margin, okay? To get a better margin. Then we also offer our continuity piece. Usually that's where we put this in at the third upsell. Now you could have as many upsells as you want. For our clients, we usually like to start with three and then we can layer more complexity on. That's another note, guys, is don't overcomplicate this. The reason the funnels that we launch are most of them profitable day one, especially the ones that we build out for clients and we actually launch these businesses for you, is because we don't overthink it, right? And also, of course, our experience helps. Me, Jordan Alley, being in, you know, online businesses for 20 plus years, we're way too old here. But we don't overcomplicate this, right? We understand the fundamentals of selling stuff online and we just do it, all right? We don't complicate it. So it's very simple, you know, five pages here, and then the last page here is just a thank you page where just they can download some products their download, their information products that we bundle in with that front end offer. If you have any questions about that, drop me a comment down below and I'll enter you into a free 30-minute coaching session with me as well. So you can see first day, $40 in sales, $19, $20 average cart value on a free plus shipping, mind you. This is a free plus shipping offer. To me, I'm like, this is fantastic. This will be able to scale very quickly. Coming down here to our campaigns, you can see we roughly made 3 purchases here, and then per purchase was roughly $825. There was a miscalculation. Seems like the pixel might have fired. It was probably me just from actually adding the pixel to the pages, where we had an additional fire on our Facebook account. So that was a little closer to $10 per purchase here, as opposed to that $825. Sometimes that happens with Facebook reporting, especially if you're going and editing pages and stuff like that. You can get some misfires here. Okay. So the way we like to kind of structure these, before I actually show you how we actually structure the ads, I like to keep everything under a 1 million interest group when I am just starting out. We use CBO, $30 a day, and all the interest groups that we have inside that CBO campaign are all under a million, right? Especially when you have a brand new business. Again, this is a brand new drop shipping business that we launched that has no customers, that has no buy, there's no data on the pixel. So for you to go and try and target something that is a million person audience, right, your results are gonna be a little tougher. The more you give Facebook, the better your results are going to be, because then they can pinpoint, hey, this is all the commonalities between all these buyers, and then they serve ads to that audience. So when I'm launching campaigns like this, I like to keep them to start at least till we get 100, 200, 300 buyers, and at least under 1 million audiences before we start scaling to those broader audiences as well. Okay, and a lot of times Facebook ads actually become a lot easier as you get more buyers, okay? But it was a good sign. We got buyers our very first day of launching these ads. Again, we create one CBO campaign, $30 a day, and we have some interest groups in there. Now, as far as interest groups, we have 3 of them, okay? We have 3 interest groups inside of a CBO campaign. The way I like to structure it is depending on what your budget is. I usually like to allocate $10 per ad set in a CBO campaign. Okay, sorry if it's a little technobabbly for those of you that guys are just getting into business here. What does CBO even to mean? Check out some of the videos down below in the description of this video. They'll kind of catch you up and bring you up to speed. This is a little bit more for those of you that are already are launching or ready to launch your funnels, or your dropshipping funnels. So here we like to have at least, if I'm gonna launch 3 ad sets, right, in a CBO campaign, I wanna at least allocate $10 per. So we had a $30 budget, and then we have three targets, 3 interests in here, all under 1 million, all right? All under 1 million. You could see some of them brought results. The other one, one did not bring any results. And the nature of CBO, it's gonna allocate the one that's getting the most purchases, which is fantastic, right? So coming down here, what you could see is we spent roughly $25, roughly $24.74, which yielded roughly $40, which isn't bad, and we acquired customers. Again, I like to take a more long-term approach when I build businesses, especially for my customers and my clients. I really try and educate you guys even on this channel, is like your goal is to acquire customers at break even or a little bit of profit. The people who can spend the most to acquire a customer wins, okay? So that's why you need to have the sales funnel with the back end monetized, because then that's all the profit, right? As long as you break even on this first step, I'm happy, because all the rest is then subscription that you're charging people on a monthly basis, as well as upsells where you are essentially getting that free sales, right? That doesn't, you're not paying ad costs anymore, right? So again, I'm willing to break even on that order form to just acquire customers, right? He who will spend the most to acquire a customer will win, right? That's one of my favorite quotes by Dan Kennedy, somebody that I consider my mentor, all right? He always says that, and it is so, so true, and it's knowledge that will be around forever, right? Those of you that grasp that concept will destroy your competition. Imagine being able to spend $100 to acquire a customer when your competitors can only spend 10, right? You can flush them out, you can become ruthless with your marketing, you can become ruthless with your AdSense, because you understand how the business works, okay? So here, these were all good signs for me when I initially saw this, when I saw this campaign after day, I was like, okay, this is perfect, this is, gives us a lot of opportunity. So give me 1 second, guys, I'm gonna take a sip of this expensive, overpriced water, and while I do so, make sure you hit that subscribe button, make sure you hit that like button for me as well. All right, guys, let's get back into it. So day number two, I'm showing you guys this because not all business is gonna be perfect day one, day two, right? There is a process to this madness. Okay, and this is why I've shown you guys, hey, look, day two, we only made $10. Only one single customer came in through the door, right? Why am I showing you this? Well, guys, because I want to show you guys the reality of what it is like running a business, all right? You're not going to, every single day isn't going to be like you turn on ads and you're just, you're banking, okay? It doesn't work that way. You have to iterate, look at these things emotionally. So when I saw this, I was like, oh man, that's a little rough. But then I looked a little bit deeper, okay? I looked a little bit deeper and I said, okay, let's look at the stats. Let's take the emotion out of it. Let's look at the stats. Let's look at what the data is telling us and make changes off of that, okay? So this is day two of running ads and I can see our opt-in rate. So again, we always want to grab that email address when customers come to us. I want to have the biggest email list of all my competitors, because at the end of the day, right, I can launch new offers, new promotions to my customers, my email list, and make free sales. I don't even have to spend ads on that. So I'm always trying to focus on building my email list. Again, for you guys on this channel, Inner Circle, Academy students, right? I'm always telling you guys, build your emails, right? The money is in the list, and the funnels, when you use them, force you to do that. So you can see here, we had roughly a 48% opt-in rate and one sale, coming out to over a 3.5% conversion rate. Those of you that are in the Shopify world, you guys don't even get 3.5% conversion rate, just so you know. Average Shopify store converts at under 2%. Yes, there might be some abnormalities in there. Those of you might be like, oh, my Shopify store converts at like 6-7%. You're a dime a dozen, and I'm telling you, plug your stuff into a funnel and you're gonna make 10x more, right? And you're not even collecting leads on the Shopify store. So here I'm collecting leads and the conversions are higher for us, okay? So you can see here on our first day, our opt-in rate was 70%. Guys, and this is a two-step order form. So when I saw that, see, I'm not even looking at the sales. I'm looking at the opt-in rate and I'm like, wow, right? Like, that's insane. Anything over a 30% opt-in rate, I'm like, yes, that's perfect. This list is gonna be so massive, so we can just continue to sell them new things every single week or every single month, however the offers are structured, and we make free sales on the back end, no ad cost whatsoever. That's why that list is so powerful, and at the same time, you're building up that list of buyers. So you can see on day one, we had a 20% conversion rate on the order form, which is, I mean, you're not getting anywhere near that on a Shopify store, okay? And again, these are very small numbers we're looking at. When you scale things up, conversions go down. So you can see roughly 48%. Fantastic. So that was day number two of running ads. So that told me, I was like, okay, this opt-in rate is really, really, really good. And the order form conversion rate is looking good as well. And you might be thinking, why would you say that, Pete? It's only 3.5. Well, I'm looking at day one as well. I'm looking at day one and day two. A lot of you analyze your data on a day-by-day basis like we're doing now, and that's not what you want to do. You don't. You always want to look at things over 3, 5, 7-day periods to see what your actual average is going to be. All right, so it was a very good sign for my opt-in page that things are looking good. I'm not going to probably touch anything there. Order form's not converting bad. And then my upsells was an issue. So if those of you that are maybe savvy, you probably see the issue that I messed up when we originally launched this one. So we had a little bit of an issue with one of the buttons not firing, and it was actually one of the upsell ones, which was just not working for whatever reason. That's a topic for another discussion. But I caught that on day two, day three, and I was like, oh crap! Like, because I knew the upsells were good, and I was like, well, why is there no traffic being sent to them? Right? What's going on? After they buy, they should be seeing the upsells, and they weren't. They were in fact not seeing them. So I caught that real quick, and I was like, oh my gosh, like, felt stupid. And I'm sharing that with you because, you know, some of you guys might look at me like I don't make mistakes, and trust me, I make mistakes each and every single day. That's how we learn. I've launched hundreds of funnels, and I still can make mistakes, right? So one thing that I want you guys to learn from that, every time we launch a funnel, I always test it, but it was just one little weird button that just was not working. And I tested the funnel, worked fine, test it multiple times. That's all I'm gonna tell you guys. Before you launch ads, test your funnels multiple times, multiple different browsers as well, both mobile and desktop, because you don't wanna, you know, and make sure you're looking at this data too. Look at the traffic, right? Look, we had 13 buyers, but why did only one person see the upsell, right? And that's when I saw that, and I was like, what is going on here, right? So I knew immediately something was wrong with the upsells, and that's a missed opportunity, but always try and catch that stuff early. And I wanna share that with you guys, because that's a lesson for all of you, even those of you that are maybe already doing, you know, 6-7 figures. Okay, so as far as ads go today, we spent roughly $27, so $28, $27.98, and one buyer, right? Only one buyer. So, you know, we lost money today, but we got emails, we got one buyer, and we caught an issue. So today, definitely the day two was definitely not a great day by any means, but I didn't change anything besides fixing some of the issues with the funnel either on day two and day three. We'll see when I caught that. But that's that's one thing. It's like, I looked at the stats over a 2-day period and I was like, this isn't bad. The stats are still good, okay? We're still profitable even day one, day two, right? When we come look at them over together, right? When we look at them together, okay? So getting into day number three. Day number three picked it up a little bit and you could see I made that fix. I believe it was the morning and I started now seeing people actually getting to our opt-in page. So now here we made $42, $21.46 average cart. I should have expanded this out, guys. We did have an order bump here as well. That's why you could see our gross sales are getting higher. Our order bump was a, just for the sake of, for you guys, for the sake of privacy, I can't tell you guys what this client's order bump is, but order bumps are basically just easy toss-in items that your customer would be buying anyway. They can be information products, limited edition products. It could be warranties, it could be gift cards, it could be whatever. Order bumps always keep them in. So you could see just from the two buyers, right? We did $42.91 with a $21.46 average cart. But look here, we had two buyers here, but only made 39. Right? So you might be wondering, well, that's because they took the order bumps and the quantity breaks. We always want to offer our customers a better and better deal and monetize as best as we can, okay? So important to understand that, guys, right? So this is why this day was much more profitable because we had, you know, we have the order bumps, people took it, right? And our average car value, $21.46, guys. $21.46 average car value on a free plus shipping offer, okay? That's insane, right? The way I like to look at this, okay? And so to me, my numbers that I just, you know, to me, the most important numbers in a business are average cart value, right? Average cart value and lifetime value, right? Average cart value is what is the amount of money an average person spends with you when they come through your funnel, right? On this day, it was $21.46. Now the lifetime value is how much does that person spend with you for the lifetime of being in contact with your business. The way you kind of build that up is by offering that monthly subscription plan. Now we haven't had anybody join our monthly subscription plan here yet, but make sure you stay tuned to that in this video because we may have had a few people join it. Okay, so the lifetime value is increased by giving your customers some monthly subscription box, information products, members area, something, right? Something where they're paying you on a monthly consistent basis. Like this is, everybody we build funnels for, all of our students that, you know, they build their funnels themselves, Academy, Inner Circle. Like I tell them, I don't start a business without a subscription in it, right? We recently had our Build Your Empire Live event here in Philadelphia where 20 people came here to have me, Jordan, Allie help them build their funnels and offers and niches. And that was like a huge section, guys, is subscription. You always have to offer your customer some sort of subscription. That way, if you have a slump in sales, which you will have slumps in sales. Everybody does. There's over a year's period, you're gonna have months where it's just like crappy sales. But guess what? When you have that subscription in there, right? That's gonna allow you to be able to withstand that, right? That's free money that you're literally leaving on the table by not offering your customer subscription. And if you're enjoying today's video, make sure you smash that like button and hit that subscribe button as well. Make sure you drop a comment down below on today's video for your chance to win a free 30-minute coaching session with me. All right, guys, let's get into day number four. Let's see what day number four has in store. All right, day number four, $64.85 in sales, which is fantastic. I saw that and I was like, yes, like this is great. But look at it, average cart value, $16.21. $16.21. So a little bit of a lower average cart value. Now you might be wondering, well, why did that happen, Pete? Why is this fluctuating so much? Well, look here, we had four buyers now, right? We had four buyers come in, but here we had two buyers come in with this much average cart and four buyers come in here, but 16. Well, why does that happen? Well, because we offer quantity break discounts, okay? And we wanna, you know, some people are just gonna buy one, some people are gonna buy two, four, six, eight, right? There's gonna be those people, those hyperactive buyers, plus our upsells and order bumps here as well. Okay, so now we can see that our upsells, this is the first full day that our upsells are actually working now, which I was really upset about this because there was missed opportunity in there, but not a big deal because guess what? The first day that we finally fixed this upsell issue, we got our first continuity member, which is awesome. So you can see this person now join a continuity program, which is gonna be paying our client $24.97 every single month on autopilot for free, no ad cost, none of that funny business. That's free money in our customer's pocket and that just continues to compound over and over and over again. That's why I recommend you guys have some sort of subscription in your business. You absolutely need to. If you don't know what you wanna put as your subscription, ask me down below. I answer all questions within 24 hours of this video being posted. I wanna make sure that you add this in, right? This is free money for you guys. And honestly, like ever since I started the e-commerce empire builders, I harp on this. so much. Every business can add subscription into it, and that will help your profitability tremendously, okay? So you can see our gross sales is our record day of $64.85 on day number four with our average cart value of $16.21. And our ad cost was roughly $30. So we doubled up, which was fantastic, right? Our purchases, four purchases that we had here, $30. I was happy. To me, I'm like, these are all great signs for a new business to be profitable. The first week, even the first month, guys, like imagine, right? Having a profitable business right out of the gate, okay? Like when you look at like actual, like not dropshipping, not e-commerce, that is so difficult to do, right? Most business models that you look out there, like agencies and maybe like other info, like that kind of, it's very difficult to be profitable day one, right? Day one of your business, okay? Even at a very small scale, okay? So, and again, look at that. Look at that. 60%, almost 59.46 opt-in rate on the two-step, on a two-step order form. That's a better quality lead as well because we get a lot of their, you know, their shipping information, email, full name, all that stuff. And it held true. 60% almost people opted in, which is insane. What was day three? 48%. So those numbers are holding really, really well, okay? So you could see here, sales conversion rate, 10%. 10.81%. Guys, I mean, what can I say? What can I possibly say? 10% is the bare minimum that we're usually going after as a order form conversion rate. 10% conversion rate on an order form is fantastic. What I told this customer, I was like, don't even touch this. And the thing is, we try and make these kind of funnel builds completely hands off for you guys, right? And we want to just do it ourselves, just handle all of this for yourself. And I was like, just don't touch anything. It's not enough. You know, we don't have enough data on the upsells yet to change anything. Obviously, the upsell, the continuity upsell is rocking and rolling. You can see this is that first day that this is working properly, right? So you could see four sales, and now we're seeing four unique page views along the way here, okay? So day number four, again, we spent roughly $30 in advertisements. I was very, very excited this day. I was like, man, like there is no better feeling when you are literally doubling up on your money in the first week of a new business. At that point, you can literally just scale it to the moon. And now day number five is our final day of this case study before we go over a little bit more stuff in detail. And this is the first day where it went over $100. Within 5 days, it went over $100 per day. Now, this was a very good day. Now, not every day is gonna be this way, as I showed you guys, where all the rest of the days. However, this showed me a lot of good signs, right? It showed me a lot of good signs, right? Again, I'm showing you guys this data on a day-by-day basis, but you wanna look at it over an average, right? You wanna look at it over like a week, 5 days, 3 days period, where you're not just looking at it day-by-day. Because look at this day, $163.73 in sales, $27.29 average cart value. Insane to have an almost $30 average cart value on a free plus shipping offer, okay? Opt-in rate dropped a little bit, right? 38.78%. This is our lowest opt-in rate. However, the people that were opting in were much more quality. So you could see six people purchased this day, bringing our sales rate to 12.24%, highest day yet for having order form conversion with essentially the most amount of traffic as well. And we finally got our first upsell buyer, right? So now the upsells are rocking and rolling. They're doing well now. Six unique viewers this day, one buyer. That gives us a 16.67% take rate on that upsell, which is fantastic. Upsells, you'll usually, especially if they're complementary products, they'll be converting between 10-15%. If they're more premium priced, more like 4-5%. That's a topic for another day to discuss though, okay? So solid day here. When I saw this, I was like, I'm so happy. For these clients, what we do, sorry about that guys, somebody, you know, knocked on my door at the worst possible time while I'm shooting a video. So you could see here, you know, $100 plus in sales for this day, highest conversion rate order form, and upsells are converting well as well. Now there's more ways to optimize this further, okay? So a lot of the clients that we do this for, we want to make it completely hands off for them, but then there's other ways that you can completely more and more so monetize to increase this order form and increase the average cart value even more so, right? There's other hacks that you can put into these funnels. That's where kind of our inner circle and our academy kind of comes into play for you. So you can see here our Facebook ads. We spent roughly only $29.20 today, yielded $163.73. I was excited when I saw this. To me, at this point, I believe it was day five. I don't believe I grabbed the screenshot of it. On day number five, this is where I turned off some of the ads. Usually, I like to look at ads and change things up after roughly 5-6 days to see, hey, you know, okay, this specific campaign just isn't yielding any results whatsoever. Even though CBO will kind of like push, you know, the budget towards the ones that are performing well, usually I'll just turn them off so no budget gets allocated. Again, though, when you're running these Facebook ads, keep the interest under 1 million, at least $10 per ad set, and then have at least 3 or 4 creatives in each interest group. That way you don't know which one, right? We had interest groups in here. We had ads where they worked for one particular interest group, but they didn't work for others, right? It's just the name of the game. You have to give Facebook as much variation as possible. Somebody can see 2 of your ads, but never buy from this ad, but finally buys from this one. So that's why it's important. Facebook, again, thrives in an environment of variation. So add as much variation as possible. And just to give you guys a little bit of closure here. So this is how the funnel's doing up to this point. We have roughly a 40% average. This is now, I believe, over a 2 week period. I believe I grabbed these stats. I don't remember, but this is roughly a week or 2 week period. I don't remember here, but roughly 40% opt-in rate here, which is fantastic, right? Order form is converting 7.62%. There's a little bit of hacks that you could put in here to bump that up a little bit more. We're only accepting Stripe, PayPal, or Stripe payments in here, but an easy way to bump that past 10% consistently is to add in Funnelish, to add in that PayPal option here as well. Upsells are converting decently, 7.84. Again, you're going to be in that 10% range here. This one's a little bit more of an expensive product here, the next upsell. So $24.97, not bad, roughly 2%. This would be something that, you know, I'm recommending change to a different kind of product to bump that conversion rate a little bit up. And then we have a couple continuity members here now paying $50 a month, which is fantastic. This is a good conversion for a full price continuity, no trial, right? Those are other things that you can add in here, offer a trial for your continuity, which we didn't put in here yet. That'll bump that to 30-40%, but I always like to get that full price option first, just to get people on that full pay right away. So you can see your $50 a month for free people are going to be getting, and an average cart value of $18.31. fantastic. That's what I'm really looking at. Again, I'm looking at the average cart value, making sure that my average cart value is greater than my cost per purchase, and I'm happy that business can scale to the moon. If you have any questions whatsoever, or you're interested in having us build your funnel, me, Ali, and Jordan, to personally pick out your niche, build out your entire offer, write all your copy, build your entire funnel out, create your advertisements, creative, your images, and actually launch the business for you, there'll be a link down below in the description of this video. This is a case-by-case, application-only basis. This is definitely not for anyone. This is for those of you that have more money than time to actually put into your e-commerce business, and you want to have something that you can kind of set, forget, and have us launch for you. That link will be down below in the description of this video. And if you guys enjoyed today's video, let me know. If you want to see more case studies like this, if this was helpful, this was very fun for me to actually do, let me know. Smash that like button. It lets us know that you're enjoying this type of content. Hit that subscribe button as well. It'll let me know. And drop me a comment down below on today's video. Okay, tell me, yes, I want to see more case studies. That way, I'll get some of these more on my calendar and start putting more of this content out for you. But guys, as always, have a fantastic rest of your day. And remember, your empire starts now.